members, all supporters to the PNM special convention and presentation of our candidates for the upcoming local government elections this Sunday, June 25th at Napa Port of Spain. Doors open at 11 a.m. You must be seated by 12:30 p.m. Action starts at 1 p.m. Assemble your teams. Wear red. And let's bring the energy as we launch 141 of your winning candidates. Be there as the political leader of the PNM and Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, speaks on the future of local government. Reform is real. Performances by top soca artists, dance, tassa groups, rhythm sections, and more. See you on Sunday, 25th June, from 1 p.m. at Napa, Port of Spain. PNM. Great is the PNM.
Join me every Wednesday morning on the street, 919 FM, 5 a.m. to 5:55 a.m. to hear For the Kingdom with the voice, Darius Lois. For those questions on life you want answered, if you question, is God real? Does he care about me? And how he functions in this world and in your life? Then tune in and get answers to those questions.
Tune in to the Street 919 FM for Gospel in the Bone Ministry every Sunday from 7:05 a.m. to 8:55 a.m. For the program, God's Last Warning Message. Hosea chapter 4 says, "Hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel. For the Lord hath a controversy with the inhabitants of the land, because there is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land. By swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery, they break out and blood toucheth blood." Remember, every Sunday from 7:05 a.m. to 8:55 a.m. for the program God's Last Warning Message with Gospel in the Bones Ministry, right here on the Street 919 FM.
Share the line. The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
Yo, this is your boy Ziggy Rankin, and right now you're listening to the Titans of Democracy. You don't know. Real talk.
Well, a pleasant good morning to each and everyone, and welcome to this edition of the Titans of Democracy right here on the street, 919 FM. Let me once again thank the Heavenly Father for bringing me here safe, sound, and all together in one piece. Pleasant good morning going out to my entire family. Good morning to the lovely Miss Sharon Felix and her entire family. Good morning to you all, our callers, all our listeners, to all of our viewers online. For those of you that are always locked on with us, it's always a pleasure to have you guys right here on the inside with us. Let me also say good morning going out to my friends and family in Tobago. Good morning. Hope you all are locked on and ready to go. Auntie Pat Nats, morning. Plus, good morning going out to the management and staff of the street, 919 FM. Good morning to Mr. Iwa George and his entire family. So, guys, at this point, we're going to open up the lines to take your morning greetings. 342-0081 and 466-5391. Those are my numbers. Call me up. Let me know what's going on with you this morning. Yeah. Caller, good morning.
Yes, good morning to you, my brother.
Morning, my brother. How are you this morning?
Good to be in the land of the living.
Yeah, man.
But the Northeast ain't looking so beautiful this morning. This weather, that easy word, Bruce. Right? Now they are 1:30, 2:00. It sounds like that.
Yeah, boy.
Well, God is the boss. We can't control nature, friend.
True that.
Morning to Sister Jenny, Sister Carol, Mommy Sauce, Shak Shak Lady, Miss Faisalabad, Miss Sylvia, down in Central. She's something else, you know. She's not easy to deal with. Brother Stilling, Mr. Chance, Rowdy Jr., Brian, our constituency group, Mr. Barataria, Mount St. George, Oi Mano, and I know your phone back in action. We can hear you this morning. You're not TV either. We have to go with the flow, but God is always the boss.
Right,
true. Stay with the one, do with the one. We don't want them back in government at all. Locked on as usual, my brother. Time for you to put back.
Yeah, man. Blessings.
Yes, thank
you. Caller, good morning.
Morning,
Bruce. Morning, my dear. How are you doing?
So true. Good morning. Miss my cousin-in-law, Aaron Hillis, Angie, Michelin, Mami Son, Tanapuna. Mercy. All the blockchain has to give my family, its cabinet, God bless him and keep him in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Later.
Yes, darling. Caller, good morning.
Yes, good morning to you, boss Wayne.
Hey, morning, Oma. How are you doing?
I'm good after the Almighty. That's it. Who there with you?
No, nobody has yet. Sharon, and come as yet.
Okay. Blessed morning to you, Miss Sharon Felix. Blessed morning to Mr. Iva George and his family. It shall continue to bless you. Blessed love to all of Trinidad and Tobago. Blessed love to all the people that listen and do call. We're saying it is a wide amount of people that just listen and don't call.
Yes.
Blessed love to Mr. Joseph in Canada. Malcolm and Gemma, blessed morning to you. Mano, good morning. Pass the street, Shack Shack Lady, the entire 919 family. And as I always say, keep the guard up, don't let it down. Now is the time to be much more wise and watchful. Take care of the children, please, and be safe on the nation's black carpet. Blessed love to all. Hold on.
Hi, good morning, Bruce.
Morning, my brother. Morning.
Yes, man. Morning to all the listeners and callers. Hey, morning, Miss Gemma. Miss Gemma, I want to tell you, I like pepper in my mango, eh? Right? I'll go on.
Yeah, man. Three four two zero zero eight one four six six five 391. Those are my numbers. Caller, good morning. Hello, good morning.
Blessed love to you, Mr. Bruce.
Morning.
Yeah, blessed love to your family this morning. Lord, you are in this morning. to give your strength us this morning in Jesus' name. Yeah, we are in the land of the living. Yeah, Miss Sharon Felix and your family, blessed love to you this morning. Blessed love to all the rest folks here on 91.9. Mr. Iward George and his family, blessed love to you. Strength goes out to you. I always give to you and blessings. Yes, blessed love to my main friend, Mano, Deep South, Barataria, and all the rest of my Titans family, like Miss Thomas, Thomas Puna, Oma Oga, blessed love to you all. Pfizer Ba, Mommy Sauce, and G. Iva, each and everyone else, Shak Shak Lady, my main family, Gemma. Yes, blessed love to all of my surroundings. Pastor, at I say. Right, blessed love to them.
Nice.
Yes. So let us keep that faith and journey going. Mr. Rowley Jr., blessed love to you also. Yeah, thank you, thank you, thank you for all those sweet words. Yes, so praise the Lord and be on the right guard, children. Trinidad and Tobago, my prime minister, who is working very hard. No, I don't care all who want to talk about you. God put you there for your purpose until when he ready for you, right? To move you, right? So you keep that faith and journey going and don't let go at all. Don't give up, yeah? Right, because I know your mind hard, I know. And I come like Sharon would say, the back broad, it does run off, right? Water does run off that back. So you keep that. Mr. Bruce Wayne, thank you so much for taking my word.
No problem. Right? Take care. Have a great day.
I love you. I love you. Nice. You too.
Caller, good morning. Morning.
And thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you. 342-0081-466-5391 and 771-1791. Caller, good morning.
Good morning to you, Pleasant. Good morning, sir.
Hey, Chief, what's going on?
Well, everything, Cooper's epic, man.
Nice, nice.
Yeah, man. So I just want to say good morning to everybody. Bataria, you know, you're on my list, your wingman. And all your listeners, callers, and everybody who is here in the station, the management and staff. And to you, Bruce, I want to say that thank you, Mr. DJ, for the songs you play.
Yeah, man.
Thank you.
You're most welcome, my brother. Good morning.
Hey, morning, Bruce.
Morning, morning, brother. Morning.
Morning, Bruce. Morning to the 91.9 family. Morning to all the listeners, Sister Jenny, Mr. Chance, Mr. Bataria, Rowley Jr., Mami. Morning, Angie. Morning, Auntie Gemma. Morning, Mother Tunapuna. Sing a song, morning. Morning to everybody locked on and listening, Bruce.
Yeah, man.
You don't know. I want everybody to have a nice day. Seek ye first the kingdom and all things will be added.
Yeah, man.
The things that will be added is not the money and it's the understanding to understand God a little more. That is the all things that will be added. I just said I'm going to train a little with the rules. Locked on and listening to the topics.
Yeah, man.
Be good. Everybody be good.
Caller, good morning.
A blessed morning to Bruce, the prophet.
Morning.
Morning, Miss Sharon Felix. Morning, all loyal listeners and callers, all one live. I hope that all you have a blessed day. Bruce, a man now say thank you, Mr. DJ, for the songs you play if you want that in here. I want to also to the management and staff, nice work. All you've been doing for the past years, I've been listening to this station. Keep up the good work. And all loyalists and callers, the information gathered, it's like a sponge in my head. Thank you very much.
Yeah, man. Blessings. Caller, good morning.
God bless you. Good morning to you both.
Morning.
Good morning, the spirits were in your bed. And good morning to everybody out there, here, there, and everywhere who looked and listened. A gentleman answered, and here it is. You cease to pray. You cease to fight. Promise the Christian number bright. And Satan trembled when he sees the weakest sit upon their knees. You see? You hear that?
Yep.
You cease to pray, you cease to fight. Prayer makes the darkest cloud withdraw, and Satan tremble when he sees the weakest state upon them. You know how to tell God plenty things that we see. Father, we thank you for another day. We thank you for the gift of life, we are in the land of the living, where we could give you thanks and praise for your redeeming grace. Continue, Father God, to bless us individually. Continue to bless us individually, collectively. Have thine own way in our lives. Help us to choose this day who we want to serve. I know I saw the trouble in compass. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. For all of forget. You see what I say here is foreign people? It's shaking the opposition and them and all them wicked, evil minded people. They don't want to hear me. Have a blessed Trinidad and Tobago. Love is the answer.
Thank you,
Brucey.
Thank you, my dear. Take care. Caller, good morning.
Hey, morning, Brucey. Mother Tuna Puna, thank you so much. We sound like a lady boy. 75 years in a boy, that lady. It's so inspirational to hear yourself, Mr. Chance. You know, as they say, the SCs, you know?
Yes.
Senior citizens, as we say, but I don't see all of that. I see all as inspirational. Morning to you, Bruce. Morning to Sharon. And morning to, you know, all listeners. Alien Man, my colleague from Tuna Puna, Angie, how are you going there? You know? And as so much to mention, Tuna, the guy from Sawa, you just want to ensure that even though you don't hear your name call in the morning, people understand that we really look forward to all the contributors on the radio this morning, 91.9. All right?
Yeah.
Later they call Mommy. She have a little input that she does on the morning, and we're grateful for that. So, Mother, nice rendition this morning. And, Brucey, thank you all for everything on the morning, brother.
Yeah,
take
man.
Care. And take care of yourself, Bruce.
We're
not here when nobody miss. Oh, man, go and get the oxtail, man, Bruce. Take it easy, brother.
Yeah, man, take care.
Nice.
I feel I might go there this weekend, yes. Caller, good morning.
Well, thank you, Jesus. Good morning, Brucey.
Good morning, my dear, and how are you?
I'm wonderful, darling. I'm wonderful in the name of the Lord.
Nice.
And good morning to you, Sharon, Angie, Juanita, Mr. Thomas, Mr. Chance, and all the faithful warriors of the Titans of Democracy, and to my sisters, Patsy, Heather, Marilyn, and Sharon. Good morning to everybody. Sending love to Trinidad and Tobago. Strength to my Prime Minister. Have a blessed day.
You too, my dear. Take care.
Bye-bye.
342-0081-466-5391 and 771-1791. Those are my numbers. You got to call me up. Call me up, yeah. Caller, good morning.
I forgot to send my love to Mr. Chance. Blessed love to you, Mr. Chance, Professor. You know I won't leave you out at all, no way. And Tobago, Tobago, love you all and all the in-laws and my family. Thank you, Mr. Bruce.
No problem, my dear. Take care. Caller, good morning. Hello, good morning.
Hello.
Morning.
Hi, Brucey. Morning, my darling. Morning.
Morning. Morning.
How are you this morning?
Hi there, cool. No complaints.
I just say pleasant good morning to you, to Sharon, to Dale, to Dominic, wherever he is. Pleasant good morning to all my Tobago counterparts, especially those on the Tobago West. Mr. Monson George, I ain't here for a long time, and you ain't WhatsApp me for a while. I don't know what's going on with you.
Mm.
A pleasant good morning to each and everyone, to listeners and callers. Have a blessed day.
You too, my dear. Take
watch
care.
The weather. Watch the weather.
Yes.
Okay.
Caller, good morning.
Brucey, good morning, brother. How are you today?
Hi there, cool, brother Malcolm. How are you doing?
Hi there, and Gemma taking a little walk around the block here, brother. We just take a little out walk.
Nice, nice.
You know, let me say morning to Sharon, Oganua. Morning, morning, Mommy Sauce. Happy Lady Mora morning. Mano, wake up, brother, wake up. Wake up, Mano. And everybody, good morning. Have a good day. And I'm locked on and listening and waiting for the Bacchanal coming up there, brother.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. So you all have a good day and I locked on and listening.
Yeah, man. You and Jamal have a blessed one, man. Take care.
Yeah, brother, we're walking around the block here. We're trying to keep young.
Hey, you had to do that, you know. Hey.
Yeah, well, the only thing I do now is eating to live and walking around the block, you know.
Really?
But I don't want to eat medicine for my supper.
Sure, right.
Which I'm not.
Sure, right.
Yeah, brother, see, you want a good one. Eat right and sleep right, and you're good to go.
Yeah, man, take care.
All right, you too, brother. Take care.
Just have about a few minutes again. Take this time to take your morning greetings, send out that love. Say a psalm, sing a song. Hey, this is the time for that. Caller, good morning.
Morning, my brother.
Hey, morning, morning, my brother. How are you doing?
Not too bad, bro.
Nice, man.
You noticed something there this morning, and every morning, the people who called it. And people who contributed something over the 6 years to my nation to bring it to where it is today, you know, Bruce Wayne.
Mm.
All these people are. Check that man from Desk Call from Florida. He is a retiree.
Yes.
I have Mr. Chance. I have Mommy. All these people are who have me where I am today, Bruce Wayne.
True that, true that.
So their experience and the knowledge that when they contribute here, on a daily basis, it's towards the younger ones who have my economy moving, who buying cars that they make in Almaty, close down Toyota, still running.
I like that.
You understand my logic, brother?
Yeah, man.
Enjoy your morning.
You too.
Thank you all for whatever you did to my nation.
Blessings.
And I hope the younger ones could build on what we have here now and move forward. Instead of we crying out, Trinidad so hard and Trinidad so bad. Look at what is going on around the world. You see the flooding? You see the men and them who go on down all that money them fellas have? You know what happened to the thing when it went down, Bruce Wayne? It exploded.
Hmm.
Imagine you go on to see the Titanic with all the money you have in the world. You go on to see the Titanic, eh? And you end up remaining right where you went to see. You make the same history that you went to make, you end up creating one. And enjoy your morning.
Yeah, man. Bless
you. Think about God and not wealth. Yeah, play a calypso a while ago. Trinidadian. What is that Trinidadian? And that is what we have to try to achieve now. Who are we? What is our identity? What are we creating? How do we live on? I see a man. You see this thing Mr. Manning was creating, the steel pan, digital steel pan? I see on YouTube a man beating a steel pan with his fingers and there ain't no pan. Digital. I set a light lighting up. Time's when my steel pan reach, you know, Bruce Wade. Enjoy your morning, Trinidad and Tobago.
Blessings, man. So, guys, we're getting ready to pay some bills. I have probably time for one more call, yeah? We could take one more call, man. Caller, good morning.
Oh, God, Bruce. At a wingman battery this morning, youths, little boys and little girls, only look around, see what it have, and go for the opportunity. You can come out of that situation that you're in and stop letting the detractors make you feel that you have no hope and you don't have nothing to do. I had a wingman that call this morning. Everybody, I love John. I'm listening. Yeah, good.
So, guys, we're getting ready to pay those bills. Yeah, you got to pay the bills. Always know that. You got to pay the bills. So keep it locked to the Street 919 FM. This is your Titans of Democracy. I'll be right back.
Expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM.
Catch all your favorite shows live on Instagram.
Yeah, we're live on Instagram.
The Street 919 FM. What are you waiting for? Go check us out on Instagram today.
Calling all primary and secondary school students. Tune in every Saturday at 12:30 p.m. for our Young Leaders of Tomorrow segment, where we open the lines and test your knowledge on current affairs in Trinidad and Tobago. Sponsored by Starbucks, Dave's Service Station, and Guppy's Service Center Limited.
This is the voice of the PNM.
PNM family. Tell me, are you ready?
Members, all supporters to the PNM Special Convention and presentation of our candidates for the upcoming local government elections this Sunday, June 25th at Napa, Port of Spain. Doors open at 11 a.m. You must be seated by 12:30 p.m. Action starts at 1 p.m. Assemble your teams. Wear red. And let's bring the energy as we launch 141 of your winning candidates. Be there as the political leader of the PNM and Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, speaks on the future of local government. Reform is real. Performances by top soca artists, dance, tassa groups, rhythm sections, and more. See you on Sunday, 25th June, from 1 p.m. at Napa, Port of Spain.
PNM.
Great is the PNM.
Indulge in an experience that awakens your senses with Nescafe Gold. Premium Arabica coffee beans, carefully selected, roasted to perfection and finely ground, resulting in a unique and unmatched unmatched flavor and aroma that captivates the senses. Enticing aroma, smooth taste. Elevate your coffee experience with Nescafe Gold.
Julia, how are our daughter Bright so?
What you mean?
Kelly's so young and already talking about when she gets her first job, taking out a mortgage with TTMF at 2%.
She knows about 2%?
Yes. 2% with no down payment as a first-time homeowner and the lowest rate on the market. We would not have to dip into our savings to set her up. Where she get all these brains from?
Her mother, of course.
TTMF, from here to home.
Join me every Wednesday morning on the street, 919 FM, 5 a.m. to 5:55 a.m. to hear For the Kingdom with The Voice, Darius Lois. For those questions on life you want answered, if you question, is God real? Does he care about me? And how he functions in this world and in your life? Then tune in and get answers to those questions.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
So Trinidad and Tobago, I'm here. Let me say good morning. Good morning to you, Bruce.
Morning, Sharon.
Good morning to all of you as callers, listeners. Good morning, good morning. Today is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Go small eyes.
Die nothing. I didn't beat you up. Don't let me tell you, cry like a man, tell my grandson, cry like a baby. Well, boy, if you hear that cry like a baby, you run and bawl. And he just, yeah, no teeth fancy, he just give me the skin of the mouth to bawl like a baby. Yeah. Boy, you will bawl. The boy that's bawl worse than them goat, you know them young goat? I say, boy, what kind of bawl is that? Anyhow, guys, I'm here. Let me say good morning to all our chatters, viewers, callers, every one of you. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. So we're going into the papers. Hey, every morning I can't, you know, I just want to miss. $20 a pot. No, $20.
For four.
For four what?
Tomato.
Four tomato in your hand?
Mm-hmm.
No, man.
I don't want to eat tomato.
And the tomato not looking so healthy. Watch out the tomato. Nah, man. All you do is that something is not that. He put the thing in the wrong place. Wrong place. Must he be truth, he wanted to say $20 or four. Can't be that. Cannot be that. Headlines. ND Express says Farley picks a fight. Refuses to hand over THA audit report to Rowley, accuses Prime Minister of deliberately misleading citizens on non-appointment of Chief Administrator. Oh, God. Bacchanal this morning. Oh, God. Right. Farmers blame price hikes on floods. When it rains, it floods, and when it floods, food prices go up. Therefore, prepare to pay more for vegetables following recent floods, and according to Daryl Rampersad, is it that? Come on, Bruce, you have to get in here.
But you see, I know fix us and put us up, so
uh-huh.
I couldn't get in.
Yeah, of the Agriculture Society of Trinidad and Tobago, floods caused by poor drainage countrywide are to blame for price increases. Okay. All right. Rowley UWI moving away from its mission The University of the West Indies, the UOWI, has fallen away from its mission in scientific research, says Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley. There are still hundreds of...
Still fighting up here. You're getting easy?
Hoping so. There are still hundreds of areas of stimulating research to be explored and published. And such publication and edification stimulated by collection and analysis of data in every field can do wonders for decision making at every level of the society, from government to small entrepreneurs, he said. All right. Farley won't make report public. Oh, God. Yay, yay. Brent makes early call on Barbados. Tropical storm Brent started its call to Barbados early yesterday, with high winds causing early damage in some communities as the island came under tropical storm warning later in the evening. Barbadians were warned by Deputy Prime Minister Santia Bradshaw to stay off the streets last night when Brett was forecast to be at its most dangerous. Residents complain of loud music, bad parking. Residents from St. Clair, St. Anne's, Belmont and Long Circular complained about loud music and bad parking during a police town meeting Wednesday for the St. Clair Police District. The meeting was held at Queen's Royal College, Port of Spain.
I tried to figure it out for the longest while. I was reading it while I was taking the calls, and I was really just trying to figure it out.
What the hell is this? Tree held with gun at health facility. Police officers arrested three men allegedly found at the Arima health facility with a loaded pistol in a purse. What the hell is this? Valencia teen missing. 16-year-old Chelsea Paponet is missing, and police officers are seeking the public's help to find her. Oh, Lord. Nigerian charged with fraud. They have all died. PNM calls for answers on Chanel. Netco recovers millions from bad pay borrowers. Hines, woman most affected by crime. Residents halt protests. And those are the headlines and some stories in the Express. In the Newsday, Mama Owe, Judge THA must face EMA in High Court. Farley, oh God, Farley, you need to bathe in some stale pee and some rock salt. 90s. Lawyers for EMBD contractor summons to appeal court. President tells students, make teachers part of your family. 50th CARICOM anniversary to be celebrated in Trinidad and Tobago.
That's going to be our next talk.
Chief Secretary Rowley misleading Tobago on Chief Administrator. THA Minority Leader, Chief Secretary is a coward. God, Kelvin. Chief Secretary, THA audit report sent to police, DPP, not PNM minority. Ex-THA chairman laid to rest today. Education minister praises Chinese embassy as six students get scholarships. Prime Minister urges society choose science over conspiracies, convenience. Health minister visits new central block of Port of Spain General Hospital project site. Very good. In quick timing, boy. CXC closes head office due to Brett. Man 56 beaten, robbed in Twin City Mall parking lot. Right. Finance Minister hosts seminar to clear misconceptions on government funding requests. Tobago budget day next Monday. Man 60 shot outside Chaguana's home. Salesman rob of dollars safe in Lavantil. Well, that's safe money. Papa. Debate rages over LGBT books. Police watch over Barrack Paul roadworks. Appeal court refuses to stop new interview for police sergeant. Wasser landslip ruins water pipes. And those are some of the stories in the news. The only today could be fire. hot like a chula. Middle whistle yet. Go ahead, sir.
So, morning again, everybody. Headlines in The Guardian. THA plot thickens. Sharon, you load on my headphones.
No.
Raise it.
I not touch nothing.
Nice.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know who does play with what.
Farley Prime Minister feud over chief administrator thickens. Augustine accuses Dr. Rowley of protecting friends named in THA audit. Tobago House of Assembly THA Chief Secretary Farley Augustine said yesterday that Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley has been spouting hogwash in his account to the nation for the delay in appointing a chief administrator. Dr. Rowley, I have no appetite for Farley's games of desperation. Obika says racial tension partly led to exit from UNC.
Poisey Mandy, wrestler.
I couldn't contribute to the organization anymore.
Papa, you.
CFO Bristow. Nikwan didn't report fire to TNT Fire Service. OWTU wants government to examine Nikwan plant's operations. Only kind of behind with that, you know. UNC to present LG candidates on Monday. Burswasser line causes hole on Charlotte Street. Sando band leader to file FIOA requests over prize money. Barrowpore residents promise to block roadway. We don't want patches. Trafficking in persons report. TNT needs immigration refugee policy. Lands in Bacolet identified for new Scarborough Secondary School. Man shot in Endeavour. Safe containing $38,000 stolen in Laventil. 91 fixed penalty tickets issued in Eastern Division. TTFA signs kit deal with Capelli Sport. Nigerian national detained by immigration officials for forgery. Early closure of CXC headquarters due to Tropical Storm Brett. And TTPS seeking help to find Chelsea Pamponi. And these are the stories in The Guardian at this time.
Outside bleak.
Trinidad and Tobago. God, it has so much of things I wanted to. So much of things I want to discuss, but I have to be quick on the draw. Tobago locked on?
As far as I know.
Okay. So many things I want to discuss this morning.
Which one you open? I follow you. Yeah, when I turn my head and look back
here. No. I open that story. I go into that story, but it have plenty stories I want to just know. Where the thing going? I open the story and I close it back over.
Well, that was saying I know. See.
Right, okay, that's okay. Listen, eh? You know, at this time, I'm supposed to be really talking local government. But I can't stay away from this THA debacle. All you help me. So I want this morning we in court. We before the court this morning, we in the court of the Titans of Democracy. And I want to tell you, this morning, please jump on the live. Iowa TV, The Street 919 FM on YouTube and on Facebook. I want you to jump on to The Street 919 FM. I need you to contribute to this morning's exercise. Come on, people, I reach, I hear. PNM calls for answers on Chanel. And it's a story by Rhea Teed, my favorite journalist. Good morning to you, Rhea. Contrary to statements made by Tobago House of Assembly THA Chief Secretary Farley Augustine, the THA Executive Council did implement the plan to hire people to do propaganda work using public funds, according to the People's National Movement, PNM, Tobago Council leader Ansel Dennis. Dennis said Augustine was seeking to give the impression that only the person or personnel, staff or personal staff of the THA secretaries were being used for propaganda work. Speaking at a PNM meeting in Calderheart, Tobago on Monday, that was Monday evening yesterday. Mm-hmm. No, sorry. Monday evening. This is wrong with me. I'm sleeping on the set.
Monday evening yesterday.
Yes. No. Dennis said the last THA election was held on December 6th. 2021, and within 2 weeks to the 1 month, all personal staff were hired. However, he said the conversation in AudioGate, a leaked recording with Augustine and another person discussing THA propaganda, took place between the middle of the middle to the end of 2022. So if you were discussing hiring people to do propaganda at that time, it could not have been your personal staff because all of them were hired by then, Dennis said. Dennis said he wanted to bring to the attention of the people of Tobago a document dated August 3rd, 2022, which was a memo to the chief administrator, who was being informed that the executive council had agreed to the creation of 7 additional positions called executive officers. But executive officers to do what? I am asking the question. Noting that in the audio in AutoGate, one of the persons being discussed was a Chanel, or it was S. Felix, not Sharon Felix. Dennis said one of those hired as an executive officer was Chanel Felix. Dennis then produced a High Court document in which Felix is the plaintiff and Augustine the defendant. He said there was a judgment summons dated August 15, 2022. He said the amount of the judgment was initially $42,632.04 plus interest. Dennis said he wanted to ask Augustine several questions. What was the nature of the court matter involving Chanel Felix and himself? Was it settled? Did Augustine pay the $42,000+? Was the matter dropped? And was the dropping of the matter a quid pro quo for this job given to Felix? Dennis said he would appreciate it if the answers is given within 24 hours. He said Felix was employed on a short-term basis in May 2022 and then came into further employment with the 7 executive officers. Her appointment was not only approved in November 2022, but was backdated to July 13th, 2022, to last a period of 3 years to July 12th, 2025, at a salary of $13,833, housing allowance of $2,000, and telephone allowance of $400. That is the payment for going on Facebook and posting propaganda, Dennis said. Dennis said when Augustine was caught via AutoGate using public funds inappropriately, he sought to say that the PNM did it too. Misery loves company, and he wants to include the PNM in their foolishness. But I want to give PNM members and Tobago the assurance that no PNM administration in this past has or in the future will engage in that kind of nonsense, he said. Morris, $165 million to contractors outside Tobago. THA minority leader Kelvin Morris said the Augustine-led THA paid $165 million on four projects, all given to contractors outside of Tobago. But all you can't pay the Tobago contractors that all you owe in. Because you find paying the Warners the $85 million is too much to pay them, right? So it is not enough, it's not too much to pay the contractors outside of Tobago. And tell me if these contractors now come and do work and they get paid already. I just asking questions. By contrast, the previous THA led by the PNM paid $200 million on 80 projects using Tobago contractors, Tobago workers, and Tobago hardware stores. He said that the contractors coming from outside of Tobago were bringing their own equipment and workers. Morris said one of the four projects was a road to Pigeon Point, for which the contractor was given to Innovate Roofing and Construction Solutions. In this $54 million contract, the THA accepted the company's bid, in which bitumen was priced at $2,700 per ton. I want to stop right here. The ad's coming up. We have 30-something seconds. But my question again, the contractors who were owed prior to election, you wouldn't pay. Are these contractors who are being paid, are they now contractors now doing work for the THA? Just asking some questions. Listen, don't shift your dial. When we come back, I'm reading the rest. And we have more articles to read, you know. I want you to prepare yourself to sit down, listen, and then call in and comment. We'll be back.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the street. 919 FM.
Is your business experiencing the following symptoms? Not enough customers, no sales, slow cash flow. It's time for your business to be seen and heard by thousands of potential customers inside this new, exciting television and social media feature.
Welcome.
The 1020 with Junior K. Up for this exciting challenge?
And confident about your business?
If you are, the 1020 feature is just for you. It's where you give your customers 10 reasons in 20 seconds why they should shop by you. This fun-filled feature will be captured, packaged, and aired on television and promoted on social media simultaneously. Small, medium, and large businesses, call or WhatsApp 764-3378 or 313-4215. Let's feature your business. 1020 with Junior K. It's affordable, effective, and fun.
Catch all your favorite shows live on Instagram.
Oh, yeah, we're live on Instagram.
The Street 919 FM. What are you waiting for? Go check us out on Instagram today.
Today.
The steel pan, the only musical instrument invented in the 20th century, is a reflection of the perseverance and innovativeness of the people of Trinidad and Tobago, which have always been central to our development as a nation. And the steel pan story epitomizes this, carved out of life and struggle and determination, rising out of the spirit of the African drum. The steel pan stands today as evidence of innovativeness, creativity, and passion for life integral to the people of Trinidad and Tobago. My name is Kwesi Paul. I am your host, inviting you to join me each and every Sunday from 7 to 10 p.m. for the Evolution of Steel Pan Show, live on the street, 919 FM.
This is the voice of the PNM.
PNM family. Tell me, are you ready?
Members, all supporters to the PNM Special Convention and presentation of our candidates for the upcoming local government elections this Sunday, June 25th
at Napa Port of Spain. Doors open at 11 a.m. You must be seated by 12:30 p.m. Action starts at 1 p.m. Assemble your teams. Wear red. And let's bring the energy as we launch 141 of your winning candidates. Be there as the political leader of the PNM and Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, speaks on the future of local government. Reform is real. Performances by top soca artists, dance, task groups, rhythm sections, and more. See you on Sunday, 25th June, from 1 p.m. at Napa, Port of Spain. PNM. Great is the PNM.
50 years they have been here giving you the best. Trinity to the bone.
KFC.
TNT is home.
The Golden Dome 50 strong, every line anytime.
Trinity to the
bone.
KFC. TNT is home.
Doors open in 1973.
St. James.
In TNT. Come join the celebration. KFC, it's finger licking good.
Yeah, this is a blessing again coming out from Yard Kitchen. Yeah, so we thank God we live to see another day. Yes, so today Yard Kitchen is shouting out. Yeah, we say we have the oxtail pizza, we have the jerkwood pizza, we have the brown stew chicken, the brown stew pork, we have the jerk chicken, we have the festival, we have everything at Yard Kitchen. Come out on a Saturday. Also, yeah, we have the soup time. Yeah, we have it. Red pea soup. We have the lamb bee soup. Yes, we have all soup. You come at Yard Kitchen. If you come, you get it. Come down with me. We have it.
Yard Kitchen TT, located at number 12 Victoria Avenue, opposite Tranquility School, Port of Spain. They're open from 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. every day for dine-in or takeaway. Call or WhatsApp us at 336-3442 and follow us on Facebook, TikTok, and Instagram. For more info at Yard Kitchen TT.
Yard Kitchen TT, for that authentic Feds Jamaican flavor.
Join Pastor Kelvin Heinerein and friends for The Way, The Truth, The Life Radio Ministry, a Church of God ministry, live on the street 919 FM from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m.
This and every Sunday
on the street 919 FM. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father except through me. John chapter 14, verse 6. For further information, contact 686-3845-349-5178 or 342-7303.
Tune in to the Street 919 FM for the program The Final Hour with Pastor Valentine Garcia Jr. and his wife Nikki Garcia for the Bible study every Thursday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Mark chapter 16 verse 15 says, "Go into all the world and preach this gospel for every creature, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation."
Turn your lights down low and listen to the Master's radio. Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
You are invited to join Pastor Morris Johnson of the Church of the Firstborn Assembly Miracle Center, located at number 399 Eastern Main Road, Guayco, in Sangre Grande, for the Old Time Gospel Hour Family Radio Ministry every Sunday from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. Mondays at 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Trauma and Bereavement. Also every Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. The Lord more. And you, Wednesdays from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., dealing with disabilities. And every Friday evening from 9 p.m. to 5 a.m., all night prayer live on the street, 919 FM, designed with you in mind. This program deals with today's issues from a biblical perspective. You will also be given the opportunity to call in and interact with us. Micah 6:8 says, "He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doeth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly and to love mercy and walk humbly with thy God." Your financial support through the First Citizens Bank would be greatly appreciated. Account number 795-2222. For further information, call 753-1113 or 236-7271.
For a new on-the-go experience in radio, simply go to your Android device and download Instant Radio. Select Trinidad and Tobago and click the street. 919 FM. So you can listen to us wherever you are.
Jason?
Yes?
I'm watching the house plan.
Yes?
What are all these little rooms?
The children's rooms.
So much? Look, let me plan the family.
Dreaming of building your home? TTMF has the ideal team to help you realize your dream. With up to 90% bridge financing for construction and much more help available, TTMF is your ideal mortgage partner. Visit us online or call today. TTMF, from here to home.
Share the live.
Share the live.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the live.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the live.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the live.
The Street 919 FM.
All right, so Trinidad and Tobago and the world by extension, I say good morning, and we are back. Tobago, and this is also a remedy for us in Trinidad to listen to. So, going back a little bit, remember where I am, eh?
Justin, my thing bonks me out, you know.
We continuing to read the article, PNM calls for answers on Chanel. That is the S Felix, not me, not Sharon Felix. Continuing to read the article, going back a little bit.
Right.
So Morris, $165 million to contractors outside of Tobago. THA minority leader Kelvon Morris said, "I forget you there. You're going?
Yes.
All right. Watch the rain, eh?" THA minority leader Kelvon Morris said the Augustine-led THA paid $165 million on four projects, all given to contractors outside of Tobago. But contrast, the previous THA led by the PNM paid $200 million on 80 projects using Tobago contractors, Tobago workers, and Tobago hardware stores. He said the contractors coming from outside of Tobago were bringing their own equipment and workers. Morris said one of the four projects was a road to Pigeon Point for which the contractor was given, a contract was given to Innovative Roofing and Construction Solutions. In this $54 million contract, the THA accepted the company's bid in which bitumen was priced as $2,700 per ton. He said Augustine had complained that the previous PNM-led THA administration had accepted bids in which it was paying what he labeled as an inflated price for bitumen at $1,400 per ton. But his administration was prepared to accept a bid with twice the cost. If what you're saying is that the previous price was inflated and corrupt, then it means what you're doing is corrupt squared, Morris stated. He said under the previous assembly, the project would have cost $36 million, which is that money Where is that money going? And who is sharing in the spoils of that? He asked. He said a road to Dutch Fort cost $19 million, but the work was assessed by a quantity surveyor to be worth $7 million. Morris said the five contractors who received the $165 million in contracts were not on the list of contractors properly registered with the THA. I want to go again. Farley won't make report public. The final report of a forensic audit into development programs conducted under the former Tobago House of Assembly Administration, THA, will not be read in the House. And neither will the THA minority nor the Prime Minister get their hands on it, says THA Chief Secretary Farley Augustine. This report will be needed to advance civil and criminal matters, and I will not want those culpable to get away on a technicality. It will appear that those opposite will like an opportunity to warn their friends and to have the report thrown out of court on a technicality. There's Farley. I go in again, only wait, hold on. Bless you, sir. Bless you. I go in again, eh?
This is news to
you. Mm-hmm. THA minority leader. Chief secretary is a coward. Tobago House of Assembly THA minority leader Kelvon Morris has accused Chief Secretary Farley Augustine of being a coward in not subjecting himself to THA debate or questioning at media conferences when he speaks on major issues affecting Tobagonians. Morris made the statement as he addressed a briefing brought live on social media on Thursday after he walked out of the 19th sitting of the 2021 to 25 session of the Assembly at the Assembly Chamber in Scarborough. He said the current administration continues to make mistakes and missteps. They are trying to muzzle the minority. They are trying to muzzle persons who do not support their views, and they are trying to find ways of preventing you from knowing the truth. Trinidad and Tobago, what does that remind you of? 2010 to 2015 of the People's Partnership. He said the sitting was another prime and clear example of the Chief Secretary Farley Augustine-led THA administration misusing the legislature as a political platform. The Tobago House of Assembly legislature is that space provided for us to have open debates. And it is also facilitates for short statements that are about 10 minutes long based on the standing order. At the 19th sitting, Augustine presented a statement on the THA audit reports as well as the absence of a chief administrator. Usually the government of the day, the administrator of the day, would bring motions so that we can debate motions that are important to the people of Tobago. To your daily life, things that would impact your life, talk about policies and even talk about bills that can fundamentally make a change in your life. But rather than the administration brings something of worth that speaks to the challenge of the Tobago people, we have all kinds of things happening. We have bread and butter issues such as employment. How do we generate meaningful employment? Morris said it was as though the chief secretary was afraid to face Tobago. When last has he faced you without hiding in the dark or going under parliamentary cover where he cannot be questioned? This chief secretary is a chief secretary that seems to not want to be scrutinized and analyzed and asked questions and be debated. He's a coward. He is taking the easiest way out. Morris said, He was advised of the sitting on Tuesday. He said, at the sitting, when he noticed what was happening, the minority decided that they would have no part of it. That is undemocratic. It is unfair to the people of Tobago who voted for transparency and accountability in governance. We are calling on the Chief Secretary to stop his nonsense, level with the people of Tobago. In fact, we are also asking, and the question is clear, the presiding officer is now duty bound to clarify whether the Chief Secretary got approval to read that statement. He added, this is the Chief Secretary's misleading the people of Tobago because we were told of a statement and achievements, and he came in the house and read something else, something completely different. Morris is calling on Tobagonians to make their voices be heard. It appears that this Chief Secretary has gone rogue. The Chief Secretary seems to believe that he is in some communist country where it is, do as I say, and no dog back. Nobody asks a question, nobody has a say. Morris said that those that challenge Augustine were subjected to victimization and personal attacks. I am saying that this cannot be the Tobago to which we want to reside. This cannot be the Tobago that we have come to accept. But you know, interestingly, I sit here and I read all these articles and know something that comes to my mind. Question I want to ask. $165 million in contracts. To how much? Four contractors?
Five
contractors outside of Trinidad and Tobago. A little vexed with me this morning. And I'm very careful that I don't get any pre-action protocol letters. But I had to ask. Will this be funding any local government election at this time? In Trinidad? For any party that looks yellow? Trinidad and Tobago, I am asking a simple question this morning. And if asking that simple question this morning, I'm just asking questions. And two are asking for friends. And if it means that anyone wants to challenge me, I'm asking a question. And if I can't ask a question, then I'll do like the minority leader. I am asking a question for some of my friends. 3420081 7711791
and 4665391.
And while I ask that question, I want to find out also, what are the racial issues going on at this time in the UNC? All yeah. Dice questions we want to answer, I know. But I want to deal with THA first. Good morning, Mr. Yates.
Good morning, Ms. Felix.
Good morning.
First of all, I just want to ask Fally Augustine two questions. Two questions, very simple questions, requiring very simple answers. One, Dr. Rowley made a claim that you sent a letter to Colm Imbert requesting $88 million to pay the Warner Group of companies in Tobago. That is what Dr. Rowley told us a few days ago when he had his meeting in Tobago. To pay specifically the Warner Group of companies for work done. I want to ask Fally Augustine, is that a fact? Is that a fact? or is Dr. Rowley lying on you? Is it true, or is Dr. Rowley lying on you? And if it is a fact that you requested 88 million and you were given 100 million, how is it that you did not pay the Warner Group of Companies the 88 million that you requested as payment for them, for that family company? How come you gave them maybe a half or quarter of that? What did you do with the rest of money? What did you do with the rest of money, Fally Augustine? You have to answer questions to the people of Trinidad and Tobago, because it's not your money. It's money that came, that is coming from the budget of Trinidad and Tobago. You can't just play badon and decide that you're not going to answer the people of Trinidad and Tobago. You can't do that. Tell us, is Dr. Rowley telling the truth, or is he lying on you? Secondly, that name that is being bandied about in Tobago, Chanel Felix, is that name in any way connected to you? Is that name in any way connected to you? And if it is, please give us the connection between you and Chanel Felix. Because there's a court order, a court decision. Is that person who has been hired by you in any way connected to the court case? Is that lady in any way connected to you and the court matter? And thirdly and finally, Obika, I'm glad that he has come across. And I expect that he will be attacked, not by the Indians in the UNC, but by the Africans, by Roberts and Naked. I expect that he will be attacked. And all he'll have to do is tell them, well, look, at least I had the belly and the courage of my conviction to walk away from the racism. Why have you all decided to stay in this den of racism and nastiness? That is what I want to say this morning. Thank you very much, Richie.
Thank you very much, Mr. Yates. Questions need answers. Ah, Papa. Good morning,
oh
Mr. Napunan.
Good morning, Sharon.
Morning.
You know, girl, let me thank the gentleman who sent me the Guardian this morning. Girl, they are reading papers and some of donkey. Well, don't talk about the Guardian. They don't know what, but it takes over 20 years I read the Guardian. And as I open it, I did also tell Sharon, I open it. Lo and behold, 3 people say, Sharon, I... Dr. and Ubika, whatever. And I really conversation with me and my politicians. And the man was sitting there with his heart and grieve for all these years, Sharon. Listen to this racial undertone with his people going on with. I just couldn't take it anymore. What your conscience? And you have a conscience. You hear what I'm saying? But you have a conscience inside of your head. And conscience, you could only take but so much for so long. The man had to come out, Sharon. But these people are going back and for Rodney Charles. Oh my God. What kind of thing that man? They don't have a conscience. Because that thing that man couldn't take it anymore. So I welcome that brother, that son. You hear? He just couldn't take it anymore. He was a vomit in a bed. It didn't come up from among them. So don't expect them to say anything good about you. KZ, when you wake up and smell the coffee, he blindly doubled. He must eat too much double. I don't know where I'm with this African. Now, I have a problem with the racial thing with the good on with you. But how you could sit up on River Stone and be talking to River Band? And how long people would take that? So, man, Sharon, I don't know how to say anything, but I read this article and I say, Lord, that was enough for the guys talk about the video. Because I read it twice, Sharon, to get it just of it. Or because, you know, I know it was wicked. You said too long. Yeah? But God is good. Nothing happened before his time. You are out of your space now. You're in the answer space, you know. Sharon, I don't have a better look than anything. Let me go back by TikTok and have a fun.
Caller, good morning.
Good morning to you, Sharon.
Good morning, and good morning.
And good morning to Brucie.
Morning.
Sharon, you know what bothers me? That the minority leader, I think he can go to the, where you can get the, to the freedom of information.
Freedom of information.
To get info. Other people or go to the court or have somebody go to the court. He must release those documents. It is, I mean, it's undemocratic. How you could just do what you want. And you know who, what hurts me too, Sharon? My heart bleeds for the people of Tobago who cannot get employment. If the contractor, the Warner people, had to lay off over 300 people, is the people of Tobago who are losing jobs, unemployed. How are they to survive? How can you do this, Mr. Chief Secretary? Don't you have a conscience for your fellow men, for your fellow Tobagonians? They are unemployed, they're bleeding. They have bills to pay. They have to live. How can you do this? And then send your money in Trinidad here and leave your people undone. That is not the Tobago way. Sharon girl, and my heart bleeds, but they can take action. The freedom of information, you go to the courts and so on and take action. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Caller, good morning.
Yes, good morning.
Morning.
I just want to make a 2 cents contribution. I'll make it quick. One with the racial issue, not the undertone, the open overtone that you all treat as undertones. This fellow named Mukesh Babaram on a program, I can't remember the name of the program. That was just Father's Day after Father's Day. And this poor creature, this Gujarat, he came up and started quarreling. Oh, he thought his in-law wanted him to come a wedding that married in one of them things. And then he said, well, Mukesh asked one of them things. He said, and Negro, he thought he fight song. He tried to hold contain the language, so he said, and Negro. He said, imagine Mukesh, I could be part of that curse to spoil my family lineage, to spoil it and destroy it. And this was sick. And Mukesh now had to cut him off and start to laugh. I tell you, every religion and thing. But this was clear from ever since. It just, but again, it reached a crescendo. It reached out terrible taste or tenor to the tone and the tongue of the ears out there. But the reality is that was what it is. It never changed. These people are who they are. They divide three nations, you know, Bangladesh, India, and Pakistan. Because they divide on kill loans. That's over 200,000. They killed the great Bangladesh in 1971. So who do you think will be the common denominator I hate? At the end of the day, they do this in Ghana. They kill them, that's and throw them in the river, in the Kaito. Right? And Farley went behind the ears, political shrimp slash junior. The father of your party, just like Griffith, don't know he plays disrespecting the Prime Minister. They have a chain of command. And if you join the party, the daddy of the party, the main carpet bagger, he can't just get in the party just so. Then you disrespect the traffic wardens can't do the duty, the commissioner, because you're bullying them. Your wife do some pauper, some infraction against the law before you try to use temperance and sense. You want to bully them. Then this thing with the seeming electoral fraud attempt to, I don't know if you're playing Donald Trump Reloaded and shit like that, but this is a kind of fraud. And yes, we know prostitution and politics is the oldest dirty game, but do it in private, but you don't know your place. And you act, and evidence is any means exclusive of my argument, you to promote this through the vaccine issue. And the fact is, on paper, you ask for 80-something million. I think they are owing, one to ask you only 40-something million. So why did you ask for so much and claim that is one? They want to settle and liquidate debts with. So there are questions to be answered, Farley. Right? Your capitalist matter is foolishness, and I hear the Prime Minister say some time back. I know I dispute with everybody, but stolen. It's not ice cream. It's feel like ice cream, but the temperature and taste and smell is different. And you know, Farley smells just as ice cream, Farley. Bye-bye. Shoot it up.
You know, first I know people voice so good, I listen to the contribution. And in my head saying, you know, this is, I forget the guy, what they call him. And he said to the end of the thing, the truth is a brute. Paula, good morning.
Hi, morning, Sharon. Morning, good.
Morning, morning.
Sharon, let me see if I can understand this whole thing with Pali. Pali fired a senior public servant in the THC. But it is accusing the man of, we say, misappropriation of funds or whatever it is, right? And he has all this information. The public, do you know what he fired for? The crime, nothing. Prime Minister, I don't know what the man fired for. And when he asked,
he fired him or they sent him on suspension?
Well, on suspension. Let me put it on suspension, but basically, I finally fired the man.
Right.
Everything
okay.
On suspension for the legal arm thing. He's gone on suspension to suspend the man. And if you haven't given the public a reason why you suspend the man and how this thing and it's great, which is going, okay. Let me schedule that to the public, but at least you only put to the Prime Minister good reasons to what you bloody man did and everything. Yet you had the kind courtesy to tell the Prime Minister that is what happened. And then you come into the Prime Minister last minute to say that you have another name because this man on thing and the Prime Minister don't know who he's going to sign and what he's going to do. Thank you, Prime Minister, but well, okay. Fali ain't no different from Putin. Russian President Putin, Fali's acting just like that. But he's going to get himself in some serious because that voice message or the voice note or whatever it is, that ain't going away. That have serious consequences on that. Because you also implicate the other members, so all of them going down too. The only concern is if charges is laid against Fali, obviously the others and them who along with them, let us call it in the law, as part of it, whether you assisted, you played no part, but you assisted in a crime, you all are as guilty of the same crime with the person who committed crime, you know. So if all of them have to end up in that problem, what's going to happen to the THA? Because if Fali's being charged, I don't think he can sit as the thing. If the police come out and charge Fali, he can't sit on there. And if the police charge them, all of them have to be charged too because they're, all of them is accomplished. Anyhow, Sharon, I cannot confuse. I listen to you all. I want to hear Mr. Chan, and I want to hear a couple of Rolly Jr. and all of them to talk at me and talk about this matter. Tobago in a real mess.
A serious mess. Thank you very much, caller. And sometime before I leave here, the ads are coming up, eh? Oh, God. I took a caller here, but I can't take you, no? Gentle, 460, I can't take you until we come back from the break. With 20 seconds, and if I take the call, let me see. Caller?
Très bien. Très bien. A tout à l'heure.
Caller, you'll have to call me back, yeah. We will end up in the ads on your face. So call me back after the ads and we'll continue. But before, sometime during this show, I have to show you what's happening in Paramin. All right, we'll be back.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM.
Calling all primary and secondary school students. Tune in every Saturday at 12:30 p.m. for our Young Leaders of Tomorrow segment, where we open the lines and test your knowledge on current affairs in Trinidad and Tobago. Sponsored by Starbucks, Dave Service Station, and Guppy's Service Center Limited.
After Freeness is...
Whoa. This is a family program.
Relax now. I'm trying to tell you something. This month at Flo, you're getting free Samsung smartphones and free installation when you sign up for the 200 plan.
That is the plan. With 200 megabytes upload and download speed, Paramount Plus and Real Channels for $299.
That is the plan, self.
Sign up for the select 200 plan today or visit online at discoverflow.co to join Tobago's newest fiber network.
on Saturday, June 24th at Napa, Port of Spain, 8 p.m. sharp. Come and experience the rebirth, the metamorphosis from cocoon to butterfly in full flight as our 2011 National Calypso Monarch and 2 times Caribbean Queen of Queens of Calypso, Corrine Ashe. Stages her first full-length concert. In concert featuring special guests Soca, Sweetman, The Baron, past and present Calypso Monarchs, Isaiah O'Connor, Dwayne O'Connor, Devon Seal, also Sheldon Reed, along with young, exciting Soca superstars, Urfanel, Sing Dog, Second Star, and Lil Bits. Also featuring the current junior national monarch, H&A King, John Thomas with the Eastern Choral Choir, Versatile, Nicholas Lucas, and more. All backed by the Oral Rodriguez and his amazing Razor Shaw Band. Get tickets now. General, $200. VIP, $350. Available at Crosby St. James, Monarchs on the Avenue, WAC Radio San Fernando, Michelle's Arima, Napa Box Office, and IslandEtickets.com. Kareem Ashe, June 24th, 8 p.m., Napa Auditorium. Come and experience the rebirth.
This is the voice of the PNM.
PNM family, tell me, are you ready?
Members, all supporters to the PNM Special Convention and presentation of our candidates for the upcoming local government elections this Sunday, June 25th at Napa Port of Spain. Doors open at 11 a.m. You must be seated by 12:30 p.m. Action starts at 1 p.m. Assemble your teams. Wear red. And let's bring the energy as we launch 141 of your winning candidates. Be there as the political leader of the PNM and Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, speaks on the future of local government. Reform is real. Performances by top soca artists, dance, tassa groups, rhythm sections, and more. See you on Sunday, 25th June, from 1 p.m. at Napa, Port of Spain.
PNM.
Great is the PNM.
Indulge in an experience that awakens your senses with Nescafe Gold. Premium Arabica coffee beans, carefully selected, roasted to perfection and finely ground, resulting in a unique and unmatched flavor and aroma that captivates the senses. Enticing aroma, smooth taste. Elevate your coffee experience with Nescafe Gold.
For a new on-the-go experience in radio, simply go to your Android device and download Instant Radio. Select Trinidad and Tobago and click the street. 919 FM. So you can listen to us wherever you want.
Catch all your favorite shows live on Instagram.
Yeah, we're live on Instagram.
The Street, 919 FM. What are you waiting for? Go check us out on Instagram today.
Today.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
Rankin, and right now you're listening to the Titans of Democracy. You don't know. Real talk.
Oh, Bacchanal.
Broadcasting from Trinidad to the world. The Street 919FM.com.
Just because
right, so Trinidad and Tobago and the world by extension, listening and viewing, I say good morning to you. We are back. And we're getting right back into our Bacchanal this Friday morning. This overcast Friday morning. Bruce, you change my music? Jump up. Guys, oh my word. Trinidad and Tobago, we have to be real careful, you know. And Bruce. Right. We got to be very careful. Careful of the people that we choose to come here every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, that I'm given the chance to speak to you, to explain how important that is. How important that is. The caller made the, before we went on the break, the caller made the comment. You asked for 82 million, is it that? Or 80 million? Something to that is 88 million. You got $100 million. And today, you have an issue. You still didn't. What you asked for the money to do, you didn't do. Huh? Tell me what the match just say, Madsen, and that what you say? The match say, Madsen. And then, on top of that, you are not prepared to answer questions, Fally Augustine. But I ask a question. You know, I ask a question this morning, and I'm waiting to see if anybody will answer me. Straight and simple. Five contractors outside of Trinidad and outside of Tobago, $165 million. I'm asking for friends. Is that in any way going to help the local government for a party in Trinidad at this time? The Yellow Party, I ask it. You know? They ask me to ask the question and I'm asking it. And I am asking the contractors who worked previous to the Augustine-led THA. They cannot be paid. But $165 million are those contractors, new contractors, who have just started work. Are those the contractors being paid? I'm just asking for friends. Nobody else but friends. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Sharon. Good morning, Bruce.
Good morning.
Sharon, is 88 million.
88 million.
And they are 100. So what do you tell
them? I don't know.
No. That's good. Like, he alone partially funded at the school, and we partially back it. That's what he is. Because he's the smartest man in Sharon. And all of a sudden, no, you can't question me, you can't see nothing. You know what I'm saying? Anyhow. I mean, it looks like we're asking for, we're asking about. But it's going across there, across here. It looks like that. But anyhow, I don't change the social, but something I must mention, because I went Labor Day Monday March, even though I banned from the union, I still went. Now, these fellows who are talking doom and gloom, and they're talking about this and that, and I would like to tell these young men, or let leave the union alone and go and join a political party. Stop, because I don't know if I wasn't a political rally, because me and nothing but union, all I want is government and government and government and government. And I don't know if Roger, the man who wrote Roger's speech, and cannot speak is the same person, because all I hear from Roger is we can evil PNM. Incompetence and government. You don't want to talk to Carolina. So, and after all this, Sharon, all the doom and gloom and the poor and the oppression workers, and after all that, you know, every man, Jack, who was on that stage, jumping in a high-end vehicle, Who is jumping on Audi? Jumping on BMW. Who is jumping on BMW? Jumping on Benz. Who is jumping on Benz? Jumping on Range. Who is jumping on Range? Jumping on Volvo. How much poor people get them to get them? Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
No, them talking about about the poor. All them jumping high end vehicle, and where do you the normal workers? Well, when they line weak, they want different places. We can't go where they went. Well, all them who the states when they line, we can't go down. We can't go online. Yeah, got a car to go in, a special car, and. If they do get to go inside there, you can't have nothing inside there because everything is pre-sealing. But you know what? You guess who they said at the union? And you know what? When I ask questions, they're banning. But they can't talk about doom and gloom and the poor and the oppressed. And after that, you jump in there for a go and go online. Anyhow, Dr. Anderson, I don't change the show. I got.
Thank you very much, caller. So it's Bacchanal Friday, yes, but we're dealing with an issue. Let's stick to it. You see, when you change the narrative, don't change the narrative for me. Call her, good morning.
All right, you deal with a specific issue. What's the issue? Is it with racism, the nonsense, or is it with Farley alone?
Well, we're dealing with Farley, we're dealing with the racism, we're dealing with...
I'll be very quick and very economic with my wording, right?
Yes.
Let me see. There's this fund by the name of Maraj. Maraj making a lot of noise, and it's the same noise you're coming back with, and it says in Trinidad and Tobago, Indians are under attack. Right? Acts under attack in the Indians, and whatever it says, it says. And then it says he will apologize because the protest attack, he will apologize if the investigation is done and proved to be otherwise. But I will not apologize. I also believe that Mr. Fagus put him out one way, there's a change that. If in terms of being provoked for singing a song, for practicing culture, and he said so much about that nobody's to him and challenging, I want to tell the Maraj man, it is also my undertaking that the biggest drug dealers after the so-called 1% is Indian people, but I don't know why you don't get them the answer.
Caller, you're asking questions or you're making a statement?
I'm asking a question. I'm not clear because he actually recently made that statement out there and nobody brought him to that. That African people, that Indians are that threat in China, Tobago. I mean, also did the same thing. So when Maraj made a kind of false statement against a group of people, right, against a race of people who have been empowered by this PM through the SPG leadership, to the gas station dealership, to the rubbish truck dealership. One family, about 5-6 of them own a rubbish truck contract. You know how expensive that is? But they saying what they want continuously without being challenged about the tax. Drive open for me. Without being put to tax. I'm pain, I'm broke.
Caller, I want you to leave it right there. All right, leave it there because... I don't want to change the narrative this morning, but I understand your drift. I want to leave it right here. Trinidad and Tobago, we continuing to have our discourse and not shifting from this at all. Only let me stay on this, squeeze the grind. Caller, good morning.
Morning, Sharon. Hey. Morning, Bruce.
Hey.
Are you changing it? Asking a question. Darren,
yeah.
If you're making sugar cake and you put salt, what do you make? Darren?
Salty cake.
What you say?
No, you make a mistake. That is what Tobagonians did when they vote for watching Duke and Farley disgusting. Now what we seeing and smelling, it is smelling good again.
Disgusting, yes. I like that one.
Caller, good morning.
Morning, Sharon, Bruce, everybody, morning.
Morning.
You see what happened when you see you get new friends and know the road to go to the airport, but you ain't worried, but all you're doing is looking around while you're going to know when you're coming back, where to pass to come back. When you see them new friends, they give you a parcel and say, hey, drop that for that fella there for me, please. I tell my grandchildren and other little children, I just tell them, your best friend in school give a parcel to drop for anybody. Tell them, I'm sorry, let them carry it for themselves because I don't know what they have in it. And this person, he didn't put any of the parcel, so he jump in and they're around them and get, you know, like if you reach up high, high like them and carrying on. But we'll watch and see what's coming out of it, okay? Bye.
Olia, thank you very much. Olia, had to bear with me this morning. I had to play two clips here. I had to play this. If I ain't played this, my name is Sharon. Caller, good morning.
Yes, good morning, Sharon.
Morning.
Listen, I just want to ask a question. When the next budget is, I wonder if Pali getting that money to play with again. Answer that question, please.
Bruce, I have your sister here. I want to get this.
The screen is here.
No.
All right, just
fix that up for me. Ooh. All of this thing getting kind of grimy, eh? Caller, good morning. Which one is this? Right, right. Caller, good morning. Sorry about that.
Sorry, no problem with that. Morning, Mother. Bruce Wayne, morning. Know something, Mother? Bruce Wayne read that. I don't change any topic. Bruce Wayne read that article. And we talk about rate.
Mm-hmm.
I am a man in charge of the Farmers Association. Tell me tomatoes. What do you say? 5 tomatoes for $20.
Yes.
Right. And here we tell me. Because the government not seeing any drains and rah-rah-rah cause tomatoes and vegetables to go up. Well, here we're
because what? The... Wait. Because what? When cleaning the drains?
Because of the government. That was what Bruce Wayne read there. Because of what the government not cleaning the drains is what caused the flooding. Created the cost of goods to go up. So Trinidadians, if tomatoes get flooded out and fall for $20, then what will happen to the cabbage and the pak choy? And that they go be healthy. So yeah, we're going on this weekend. Since they're so using the way of agriculture to be racist, don't go in the market because if everything flood out, then it can't be healthy to eat, right? Stay away from the cabbage and pak choy and thing this weekend and lettuce. Okay?
Enjoy your day, Father Jesus, this them out. Oh, God. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Sharon and Bruce Wayne.
Morning.
How are we all going there?
Good.
Yes, darling, I see that. You're very, very good. And things going very nice. Back on all Friday. I want to say this morning, good morning to everybody, Trinidad and Tobago, and the Titan. I would like to shout out to Manu, Shak Shak Lady, Mr. Nakura, the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago, have a blessed morning with you and your family. And I have a birthday, my niece, birthday today. She was in the Coast Guard and she was the first lady that was in the Coast Guard.
So, Fish Auntie, you know, when yes. I heat of this thing, you know, it is coming and break my momentum.
Yes, I was the topic. Out of this thing, but I'm making it short. Okay? Mm. Everybody have a blessed morning and a good day today. Okay? Bye-bye.
Thank you, darling.
Right.
Ollie, don't break my momentum this morning now, please. Let me stick to the little topic quick now. I want to deal with this.
You want to press clear?
And if I don't deal with this, you know what will happen? It will be swept under the carpet and people wouldn't remember what St. Duke said. The people in the countryside, they don't read. We have to explain it to them. Because we will continue making the mistakes over and over. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Sharon.
Good morning, caller. Good morning, Roberto.
Morning. Morning, Bruce.
Morning.
Sharon, I listened to the gentleman there that he said that, you know, somebody made a statement that the East Indian people are under attack. But I want to find out, if that is so, how come one pundit come out and complain about home invasions in one location and it stopped? Police can't get to stop it. How come this won't stop it? Only think about that for a little bit, and then I go talk to Olia next time. You all have a nice day.
Thank you very much. All right, so guys are asking for us to complete this exercise.
Turn your volume down.
Yeah, I did that before. Mm-hmm. I want you to listen. I want you all to listen. Jenny, after you, I want to play some clips. Go ahead.
Hi, morning, Miss Felix. Morning, Bruce. Morning.
Oh,
this situation in Tobago, it speaks race, power, and hate, right? Joke, I always tell that Sally's worse than Joke. Some people couldn't understand what I meant. And I simply meant, we know what Joke gives. Joke tell us straight, I come to make friends, I come to make money. And he did everything to make the money. Women may not be the right way to make the money. However, Sally has always been presented as the good boy, the church boy, the Seventh Day Adventist, and the choir boy. And Sally underneath, in my opinion, I guess I know, is more treacherous, more dangerous than what Prince Solomon do. And the thing about it is he's been supported, in my opinion, by intellectuals in Tobago. And that's what makes it even more dangerous, because he's on a high right now. He's an experience and he has power. Tobago has been fed a lot of hate about Trinidadians, and I think it comes from the era of A&R Robinson, rest his soul, very intelligent man, very intellectual man. But whatever falling out he had with Dr. Eric Williams back in the day, I think in Tobago, he may have spilled all that and it would have been fed, probably intentionally, unintentionally, to people at Tobago, this hatred for Dr. Eric Williams and hatred for PNM and, by extension, people in Trinidad. It is something as it like back in the day when the intellectual Indians used to go to the Mandiris and preach to them, to the illiterate devotees. Is the reason why I'm using illiterate, because Duke said that about Roxboro people. The illiterate devotees, that the Africans, well, I wasn't using the word Africans, the African in Trinidad didn't want Indians to have anything. And that fostered a hate and a resentment against African people in Trinidad. That goes back to the date of St. Bernard Capaldeo and the whole crew and come right down to Ballistag and Mirage. And I think that is exactly what happened in Tobago with A&R Robinson. So this thing that they have for us is a deep-seated hatred. And it's unfortunate, because I do not think that Trinidadians who would have supported domestic tourism in Tobago, anytime you miss, we in Tobago, proud of our Tobago heritage, proud of our family, because thousands, hundreds of thousands of Tobagonians are living in Trinidad, unprovoked. Nobody does them. I think they live amongst us and we are one family. And this hatred that Anthony James, Max James, Trevor James are calling the names, you know, because these people are the ones supposed to be guiding this young man on the right path. Instead, they're only pumping his head.
If he don't want guidance, they can't guide him. Leave it there. We're going to the break and come back. When we come back, have some videos to play. Don't shift your dial.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the street. 919 FM. Catch all your favorite shows live on Instagram.
Oh, yeah, Instagram. We're live on Instagram.
The Street 919 FM. What are you waiting for? Go check us out on Instagram today.
Yeah, this is a blessing again coming out from Yard Kitchen. Yeah, so we thank God we live to see another day. Yes, so today Yard Kitchen is shouting out. Yeah, we say we have the oxtail pizza, we have the jerk goat pizza, we have the brown stew chicken, the brown stew pork, we have the jerk chicken, we have the festival, we have everything at Yard Kitchen. Come out on a Saturday. Also, yeah, we have the soup time. Yeah, we have it, red pea soup, we have the lamb bee soup. Yes, we have all soup. You come at Yard Kitchen, if you come, you get it. Come down Whitney, we have it.
Yard Kitchen TT, located at number 12 Victoria Avenue, opposite Tranquility School, Port of Spain. They're open from 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. every day for dine-in or takeaway. Call or WhatsApp us at 336-3442 and follow us on Facebook, TikTok, and Instagram. For more info, at Yard Kitchen TT.
Yard Kitchen TT, for that authentic Feds Jamaican flavor.
This is the voice of the PNM.
PNM family, tell me, are you ready?
PNM
all members, all supporters to the PNM special convention and presentation of our candidates for the upcoming local government elections this Sunday, June 25th at Napa Port of Spain. Doors open at 11 a.m. You must be seated by 12:30 p.m. Action starts at 1 p.m. Assemble your teams. Wear red. And let's bring the energy as we launch 141 of your winning candidates. Be there as the political leader of the PNM and Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, speaks on the future of local government. Reform is real. Performances by top soca artists, dance, task groups, rhythm sections, and more. See you on Sunday, 25th June, from 1 p.m. at Napa, Port of Spain. PNM. Great is the PNM.
For a new on-the-go experience in radio, simply go to your Android device and download Instant Radio. Select Trinidad and Tobago and click the street. 919 FM. So you can listen to us wherever you want.
Turn your lights down low and listen to the Master's radio. Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
You are invited to join Pastor Maurice Johnson of the Church of the Firstborn Assembly Miracle Center, located at number 399 Eastern Main Road, Guayco, in Sangre Grande, for the Old Time Gospel Hour Family Radio Ministry every Sunday from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. Mondays at 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Trauma and Bereavement. Also every Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. The Law and You. Wednesdays from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Dealing with Disabilities. And every Friday evening from 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. All Night Prayer Live on the Street, 919 FM. Designed with you in mind. This program deals with today's issues from a biblical perspective. You will also be given the opportunity to call in and interact with us. Micah 6:8 says, "He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doeth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly and to love mercy and walk humbly with thy God." Your financial support through the First Citizens Bank would be greatly appreciated. Account number 795-2222. For further information, call 753-1113 or 236-7271.
Looking for a safe and relaxed professional massage therapist and nutritionist? Look no further. Nature's Touch with Empress Judy and Associates offers a natural approach to better health. Treat yourself to a professional massage therapy and nutrition advice in a safe and relaxed atmosphere. Rejuvenate your body, mind, and soul at Nature's Touch Therapy. For an appointment, please call or WhatsApp 1-868-398-8282. Or visit our Facebook page. Remember, your health is our responsibility at Nature's Touch.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
Push up, baby.
Bacchanal in the country, I ball like a cow. A girl want me marry, she want me marry now. Went and do evil thing to me in order that I should marry she. A voodoo man tell me they have my name in the cemetery. They put my family against me just so. A voodoo man tell me they give me dead
people.
They have me tied from my head to my toe. Don't care how I try, I properly tie. I want to go, let me go. I want to go, want to go, let me go.
All right, so Trinidad and Tobago, we are back. We pressed for time. We have some housing and we have some videos to play. And you know, I have to show you what's happening in Parham. I don't care what time I do it. I'm going to do it. So, guys, Bruce, this is your time.
Yes. It's her first full-length concert, The Rebirth, with special guests, the Baron, current and former Calypso Monarchs, and Devon Seals, along with Sheldon Reed, versatile Bevon, Kevan Calise, current junior Calypso Monarch, and more. With soca stars, Finals, Second Star, Ding Dong, and Lil Bits. It all happens on June 24th at Napa Auditorium, Port of Spain. It starts 8 p.m. sharp. Don't miss it. General tickets are $200, VIP $350. Tickets are available online at islandetickets.com. Pay-per-view at WAC TV, The Rebirth, and Crosby's St. James Monarchs on the Avenue, WAC Radio San Fernando, Michelle's Arima, Napa Box Office, and Castro's in Aruba. Tobago After Freeness is more speed and better TV. Get a free Samsung smartphone and free installation plus 200 megabytes, Paramount Plus, and more for only $299 with the Select 200 plan from Flow. Visit online at discoverflow.co today. Tired of the same old fast food every day? Ready to try something new to get your taste buds dancing? Come on down to Yard Kitchen TT, located at number 12 Victoria Avenue, Port of Spain, for that authentic Jamaican cuisine. Items such as jerk coat, jerk pork, Jamaica-style curry beef, Jamaica-style curried pork, straight out of a Jamaican kitchen. They also have a brick oven pizzas with toppings ranging from seafood to jerk meat, pastas, salads, and soup Saturdays, beef, oxtail, cowheel, seafood, and lambi soups at the Yard Kitchen TT. Yard Kitchen TT, located at number 12 Victoria Avenue, Port of Spain. They are open from 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. every day for dine-in or takeaway. Call or WhatsApp at 336-3442 and follow them on social media for more information at Yard Kitchen TT. Yard Kitchen TT, for that authentic Jamaican flavor. The Street 919 FM is now going live on Instagram. Follow, like, and share our page as you can see all your favorite shows live on Instagram at The Street 919 FM. A round of applause for the new thing to order, KFC Crispy Barbecue Zinger. A brand new sandwich for you to devour, KFC Crispy Barbecue Zinger. Welcome to the main course, a zinger with cheese and a barbecue sauce. Crispy onions, make it like a boss, from KFC. Come taste it first. Yes, a round of applause for the new thing to order, KFC Crispy Barbecue Zinger. It's as delicious as it sounds. Enjoy the new Crispy Barbecue Zinger now for only $39.95 from KFC. For a new on-the-go experience in radio, simply go to the Play Store on your Android device and download Instant Radio. Select Trinidad and Tobago and click the Street 919 FM so you can listen to us wherever you are. Nescafe Gold Premium Arabica Beans, exceeding your coffee expectations. Experience the superior coffee taste of Nescafe Gold Blend, uniquely rich and smooth, the flavor to be savored. Nescafe Gold, awaken your senses.
All right, so guys, we're getting straight into it. With no delay, we're getting straight into it. I'm playing some clips and I need you to jump on the live. Yes, YouTube, it was just 700 and way plus. You're going down to 713. Come on, guys, up back my numbers here. Get on the YouTube channel, it's Iowa TV, The Street 919 FM, or on your Facebook page, The Street 919 FM. Come on, guys, I want you not to just here, I want you to see. So jump on.
I've been reacting. He's elected to lead on all the concern in Tobago. He ought to be addressing the nation and to speak to all those issues. But he has not been doing that because he doesn't have, he's not a leader. As I said, Mr. Duke formed his thing and he happened. And much of the executive council also just happened. Most people say it was 9 or whatever the time that he's going to come, and you can't find it. And after a while, I just, if somebody after about 20 minutes called me to say, well, it's going on and so on and so. There should have been a media briefing. That is not a media, well, a media conference with the journalists to face the public. He deliberately did not go down that road because he's not in a position to answer questions. And so that the narrative he came up with, he's not really confident about it. If he was really...
Let me see if I can play the other part for you. I want you to listen. Not me saying it, you know.
Okay. Only the weak-minded. Those who are very susceptible and vulnerable, you know what I mean, light-headed. He can only convince those, the fanatical supporters, and will accept that, right? So it all comes down again to shaping the narrative. That's what he's going to say. He's the, instead of coming clean, for instance, I'm hearing on another network yesterday that another television host, as the case may be, was asked to apologize. You follow him? Misrepresent us, betrayed our trust, and so on, not knowing that we will find out that he was planning to betray our trust. And you're having people now responding spontaneously based on how they feel and assess. And people have been asked to apologize. But here it is that the chief secretary and his executive council have not apologized to the people. In fact, they're really defending, and that's dangerous. They're actually defending. So you say, well, we explore everything. It is what we always do as politicians, you know. We explore the good, the bad, the ugly, the whatever, and obviously, and evidently we didn't do anything about it. You know what I mean? It's disingenuous to come to see what you would discuss. So they came up, the time they spent by themselves there in private, they came up with a defense.
The narrative.
And they came up with a narrative, and they felt that was good. But clearly, in my judgment and the population's judgment, that they didn't deceive anybody there. Mm-hmm. Of course, the loyal supporters will continue to support. And it's not really, I'm telling you this, it's not really the executive council, Mr. Augustine, that people are really supporting. When I say people hold on to that which is not plausible, they're really defending themselves and what they can get out of it.
Woo! Woo! I hope all you're hearing what the man say. I hope all you're hearing what he said. I want to come a little further here. 200 and... Wait just now. I have to find the right space that I want to play for you. The right space. Just now. Don't move. Right. 219. Good. This thing going back.
Narrative. Narrative. Is very, very critical to what is going on, because it has become a stroke, perhaps a master stroke now. It's all about shaping the narrative. It's a very dangerous terminology, really, because in large part, given the context in which it is used, it is all about primarily to manipulate people. It is not based on anything genuine. It's all about shaping. And to back that up, you wanted to hire people to shape and to capitalize upon the moves that were taking place in Trinidad. And the people like me, in Tobago, will react if Tobago's sovereignty is threatened, and so on. You know, so they were talking about shaping a narrative, really like capitalizing, because the executive is not leading anything where... what they call autonomy. I don't deal with autonomy. I deal with the sovereignty of the people of Tobago. There's no leadership there, but rather to stay from behind and take the catch that slips in and capitalizing and so on. So I was really, really shocked to when I found out that is the entire executive council.
Yeah? And what about even the explanation given by the chief secretary stating that, you know, they discuss everything, whether it's a good plan, whether it's a bad plan. It doesn't mean that they are going to act on it, but they flesh it out and then they decide after. You know, I mean, was that a sufficient?
No, was that unacceptable? I don't accept that. Okay. Only the weak-minded, those who are very susceptible and vulnerable, you know what I mean, light-headed. He can only convince those, the fanatical supporters and so on, but no logical, reasonable person, no self-respecting Tobagonian will accept that, right? So it all comes down again to is shaping the narrative.
Shaping the narrative. I want you to understand, you know, that word narrative, that is an important and a big word in this society today, you know. People, it's 8:14 a.m. I'll take a couple more calls. Call me on 342-0081-771-1791.
And 466-5391.
I don't know. Shaping the narrative. Tobagonians and Trinidadians, I've come and sat on this chair on many occasions and I've spoken to you all in its entirety. And I'm getting down in age, so it ain't gonna be all the time I could climb up these steps here. I just putting all you on a little bit of the narrative. Because let me tell all you something. Whatever happened in Tobago affects Trinidad. And what happened in Trinidad affects Tobago. We are Trinidad and Tobago. And if this is the kind of nonsense taking place in Tobago and only one secession, God help us. God help us. We're not moving away from the narrative and the propaganda, you know. We're not moving away from that, you know. Because it is there. Likewise, we're getting ready for a local government election in Trinidad. And you hear the UNC calling for people to join up with them in order to beat the PNM. That's how they just put it, because they can't do it alone. But Gary Griffith sent in to tell her where he want, what seats he wants. He want the trouble seats, So he want La Hoqueta, he want Port of Spain, he telling her what he want. Well, I want to tell him this morning, the people in La Hoqueta say, until they get back the susu money, don't come up there at all. So careful. I'm just telling you what somebody sending, telling me. The people in Lakota say they want the susu money. I don't know what they mean by that. You know. Trinidad and Tobago, if you all are not calling me, I will move on to my other topic. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Sharon.
Good morning.
Yeah, the one thing I want to say concerning the house, you know, Sally has a witch, this was not figured, like Trevor, like one of the James, huh?
Yes, that's one of the James.
You know, you had said, Jenny had said something just now, but I want to go a little different to that. You know, you're saying that Fali, they're telling Fali what to do and they're saying, but it looks like they're telling Fali and he's not listening also too, if you understand what I'm saying. I believe that for they must be talking to him and he want to listen to neither. And plus, she had said something that is related with what's in you. You know what you was getting. But Fali didn't know because Fali deceived them, you know, as the nice boy. I was listening to the assembly yesterday. I think I passed you on listening to me. You know, man. So I need to see Fali was like out of control. I listened to that man. That man getting on like a king in Tobago. I watched that man attitude. And Kevin Morris was talking about it before with the time and all them things, you know. Tobago in real trouble, Michelle. And these people, and some of them supporting this man still. And according to the guys, the food that they're eating, and they're supporting for themselves. Because look at the attitude of Fali, you know. Fali believe he's king in Tobago. He ain't respect nothing. Imagine that contractor thing with the UFP, eh? And all he was preaching that all the soul of Tobago Union and must be Tobago Union first. But look what you do. All that money, most of that money going to Trinidad contractors. Something has to be wrong. And if Tobago Union supporting that, he seem to be young who like to play the love Tobago and they want Tobago to go forward and they want everything in Tobago, something wrong. If they want secession, they might still take contractors from Trinidad. What going on?
Thank you very much. Let me say good morning to all our viewers on our YouTube and on our Facebook channel. Good morning to you all. And I want to tell Ralph Abercrombie, if you're now jumping this fray, wash your stink foot and make sure you're jumping to your outer place. Your outer place, right? And people like Ole will make people don't come to the store if you work in Massimoto's. If you know I talk in wherever, all you have to do is just change. Just go to somewhere else where you're comfortable. I am reading somebody sent something to my phone. If you don't know how the program does run, you're coming to tell me about something about TTPS. Look, Ralph Abercrombie, know your damn place here. Know your damn place. Go and look to see about the people cars in Massimoto's and see if you could sell them. Know your place. And if you don't know how this does operate, knock before you come in. You don't know your damn place? Who do you think you're talking to? All right, so Trinidad and Tobago, I want to shift gears in a little bit. Caller, good morning. Is this Manu? Caller, good morning.
In 2010, the people of Trinidad decided that they want to change. And God gave them a change, and the people of Trinidad voted two PNM representatives. In Tobago, the people of Tobago decided they want to change. And God to believe for the water change in the anything that happens in the
Trinidad. It's a Trinidad.
Look, you aren't listening to me now. You listening to the radio. You listening, you have to listen to me on the phone. We're doing this too long. Manu?
Morning, Sharon.
I tell you, these people really
morning,
disrespectful, you know. Boy, listen, and you know, you only feel that I will block and not blocking all you. Who is a slave descendant?
Like,
God, boy, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
What a good
anyway, let me say morning to you. I'm trying to be a man. I'm so serving right past the street. Since Mountain George, you're big. Mr. Napuna, the man of Carol and Jenny. You know, the whole person is our man, everybody. This morning, again, I played because the radio ain't coming on. I was supposed to go on 4 o'clock in the morning, you know what I'm saying? So, again, and then the place dark in the morning, and then you're home alone, you train yourself below the blanket like Miss Rina. Train yourself below the blanket, and you come up. Yeah, as soon as I get up, I hear your voice going, who are you there?
Bruce here.
Morning, Bruce.
Oh, Emmanuel.
Yeah. Well, they take it like this. Just remember, stay loving people. Don't get vexed with nobody. Let them get vexed and raise the pressure. Let them give it when they see them, they give it and then pressure rate take it for long and then. But you just love everybody. So, everybody who are forget to call their girlfriend good morning, their machine good morning. So, love everybody. Morning, guys, and all the chest. Remember, they give somebody something, say something about the God, there's somebody who's on the air. I'm on.
Mm-hmm. All right, Manu. Long time, I don't hear you. Right, Rowley Jr.
Hey, Sharon, morning to you and morning to Bruce again.
Morning. Yeah,
listen, what I'm hearing here and nationally, I mean, you know, I want to reiterate, I always treated Tobagonians in conversation with the greatest of respect because prior to this particular election, Sharon, Tobagonians had given everybody a chance. Now, they were warned about the whole question of the language, the disposition, the way Fali and they were moving, that you had a UNC-type model. And that is dangerous. The UNC got a mandate of 29 seats based on promises that were fake. I mean, the question of when they advertised pension at 60 was enough to make people gullible. And they went for that. And then you had ex gratia payments. So they were just copied models, and then people went and gave 14-1. That 14-1 turned out to be the same way the UNC governed. Disrespect. No respect for Dr. Rowley, remember? And we want to remind you all, they had 29 seats and had a no confidence motion in a man of 12 seats. And finally, I would have thought about two areas of his governance. One is that, listen, you won the seat, move on to govern, but show Dr. Rowley, even as a black man, same respect. And Fali don't. And it's such a shameful thing today to see that where Tobago has become. And Sharon, let me tell you something, eh? You can see the elderly people now who supported Fali and they, for whatever purpose, they are retracting now because a lot of Tobagonians are full with protocol, you know. They are full with protocol. And I want to say across the board that Tobagonians are terrible people because I've always respected them. But I want you all to do introspection and know that you would go nowhere currently with the leadership of Fali as a senior. You wouldn't go anywhere. He's right there staying in office because when you look at the millions of dollars being spent in Tobago for, let's say, a population of just 60,000, you all are blessed. You all are blessed. But how that money is carried currently, you all need to do introspection and let Fali know fully that there is no way he can continue leading Tobago in this condition. It's really terrible, really, really terrible, Sharon. I'm ashamed. But I love Tobagonians, but you all, the standard we expect in Trinidad, based on who you all voted in, it's dropping badly. And pay attention to that. Sharon and Bruce, thanks very much. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you very much. Aye, aye, aye. That would not be spoken to. Caller, good morning.
Sharon and Bruce.
Yes.
Morning. If you own the Warners, most likely some of that $88 million would have been accumulated over time. So you're talking about bills over 120 days that is outstanding by the PA, owed to the man. So Fali's not disputing that he owes the man that because he asked for the $88 because he had to pay Warner. The government gave him $100 million. So in other words, what the government did, and the doctor already explained why that happened, because that happened when COVID and the whole island went on a go slow. In order to keep the economy rolling, you have to pay these fellas. The fact that Dr. Rowley and the man go and borrow that money to give to not only Fali alone get money, that other areas that the money had to be distributed to pay people so they could keep the employers and them on the roster instead of having to send home people because of these people. Fali got the $100 million. So he didn't give the 88. So he had to add the 88. The 88 plus the difference to make up the 100. He gave you Warner $25 million. So you're minusing that. Fali, where do you balance the money? That's real money that you have in your thing there. On top of that, Fali, The Warners who do the job in Tobago and they're doing that for all the years, where Farley never even bring up when he was in the opposition in Tobago that problem with the Warner and this and that. You find it fit to take a Trinidadian, bring him across there, anything. On top of that, now the Trinidadian has no track record in paving anything. So I, one would assume, especially me, is that if he has a startup, he needs to lease equipment or buy equipment. Any which way. Then he has to mobilize the equipment to send it to Tobago. That comes at a cost. That comes at an upfront cost. So I'm asking Farley, did you, in the contract, did you overprice the contract to give to the man? And what sense that making? And on top of that, Farley, you're talking about the Prime Minister and the man telling you pay the friends and family. Farley, you made it absolutely clear that nobody in Trinidad can tell you what to do, not the AGI, not listening to no AGI, not listening to that. So what do you think that the Finance Minister will, you will take any advice from the Finance Minister on who to pay? Farley, come on now, man. Come on. You have real questions to answer and you're hiding. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Guys, the ad's coming up. We have 8 seconds and counting, and we'll be back. When I come back, we shift gears. I need to put up and show you what's happening in Paramin.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM. After Freeness is...
Whoa, 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 whoa. This is a family program.
Relax now. I'm trying to tell you something. This month at Flo, you're getting free Samsung smartphones and free installation when you sign up for the 200 plan.
That is the plan. With 200 megabytes upload and download speed, Paramount Plus and Real Channels for $299.
That is the plan, self. Sign up for the select 200 plan today or visit online at discoverflow.co to join Tobago's newest fiber network.
Calling all primary and secondary school students. Tune in every Saturday at 12:30 p.m. for our Young Leaders of Tomorrow segment, where we open the lines and test your knowledge on current affairs in Trinidad and Tobago. Sponsored by Starbucks, Dave's Service Station, and Guppy's Service Center Limited.
On Saturday, June 24th at Napa, Port of Spain, 8 p.m. sharp, come and experience the rebirth, the metamorphosis from cocoon to butterfly in full flight as our 2011 National Calypso Monarch and 2 times Caribbean Queen of Queens of Calypso, Corrine Ashe. Stages her first full-length concert. In concert featuring special guests Soca, Sweetman, The Baron, past and present Calypso Monarchs, Isaiah O'Connor, Dwayne O'Connor, Devon Seal, also Sheldon Reed, along with young, exciting Soca superstars Urfanel, Sing Dog, Second Star, and Lil Bits. Also featuring the current junior national monarch, Agent A King, John Thomas with the Eastern Choral Choir, Versatile, Nicholas Lucas, and more. All backed by the Oral Rodriguez and his amazing Razor Sharp Band. Get tickets now. General $200. VIP $350. Available at Crosby St. James, Mornox on the Avenue, WAC Radio San Fernando, Michelle Sarima, Napa Box Office, and IslandEtickets.com. Corrine Ashe, June 24, 8 p.m., Napa Auditorium. Come and experience the rebirth.
Islands in the sun, together 50 strong.
KFC, it's finger licking good.
This is the voice of the PNM.
PNM family.
members, all supporters to the PNM Special Convention and presentation of our candidates for the upcoming local government elections this Sunday, June 25th at Napa, Port of Spain. Doors open at 11 a.m. You must be seated by 12:30 p.m. Action starts at 1 p.m. Assemble your teams. Wear red. And let's bring the energy as we launch 141 of your winning candidates. Be there as the political leader of the PNM and Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, speaks on the future of local government. Reform is real. Performances by top soca artists, dance, tassa groups, rhythm sections, and more. See you on Sunday, 25th June, from 1 p.m. at Napa, Port of Spain. PNM. Great is the PNM.
Julia, how are our daughter bright so?
What you mean?
Kelly's so young and already talking about when she gets her first job, taking out a mortgage with TTMF at 2%.
She knows about 2%?
Yes, 2% with no down payment as a first-time homeowner and the lowest rate on the market. We would not have to dip into our savings to set her up. Where she get all these brains from?
Her mother, of course.
TTMF, from here to home.
For a new on-the-go experience in radio, simply go to your Android device and download Instant Radio. Select Trinidad and Tobago and click the street. 919 FM. So you can listen to us wherever you are.
Yeah, this is a blessing again coming out from Yard Kitchen. Yeah, so we thank God we live to see another day. Yes, so today Yard Kitchen is shouting out. Yeah, we say we have the oxtail pizza, we have the jerkwood pizza, we have the brown shoe chicken, the brown shoe pork, we have the jerk chicken, we have the festival, we have everything at Yard Kitchen. Come out on a Saturday. Also, yeah, we have the soup time. Yeah, we have it. Red pea soup. We have the lamb bee soup. Yes, we have all soup. You come at Yard Kitchen. If you come, you get it. Come down with me. We have it.
Yard Kitchen TT, located at number 12 Victoria Avenue, opposite Tranquility School, Port of Spain. They're open from 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. every day for dine-in or takeaway. Call or WhatsApp us at 336-3442 and follow us on Facebook, TikTok, and Instagram. For more info at Yard Kitchen TT.
Yard Kitchen TT, for that authentic Feds Jamaican flavor.
Catch all your favorite shows live on Instagram.
Oh, yeah,
Instagram.
We're live on Instagram.
The Street, 919 FM. What are you waiting for? Go check us out on Instagram today.
Today.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
Get your woman, I'm not your woman. Get your woman, I'm not your woman. She tell him. Get your woman, I'm not your woman. Get your woman, I'm not your woman.
So Trinidad, Tobago, and the world by extension, listening, viewing, commenting. We're getting ready to leave in a short while, but you know, I tell you, we had to shift gears, and I must give you, after all the bacchanal, I must give you something nice, you know, mellow, soft. Let me say good morning to all our viewers, all our listeners, all our chatters on our Facebook page, on our YouTube channel. I seen Karen Field Spooner. Karen Gill, what's going on? You know who is this person here? You know, whenever we had the boat ride and thing and we went all over, there's a tall, dark lady She's and she when they became something she always tell me, Brucey, a tall, dark, slim lady from up by me.
Miserable.
Yes, that's her daughter.
Okay.
Karen Phyllis Pooner. So guys, we are back. We are back. We are back, and I want you to log on back. We were just 800 and plus. I want you to log on and see this because you know the narrative and the propaganda is to be negative in this place.
Sure.
So while I talk about Trinidad, I want to tell you what happened in Tobago too, and I want to tell you what happened in Trinidad too. So while all the negativity going on, right? This PNM government has been working very hard. Let me say good morning to my public utilities minister, Minister Marvin Gonzalez. Good morning to you, my dear. You know you're my darling. Good morning, Mr. and Mrs. Regis. Oh, God, I want nobody jealous this morning. Mr. and Mrs. Primus, Mr. and Mrs. Chance. Good morning to everybody and all of y'all are my darlings. But, oh, gosh, boy, when it's good, it can't be better. Anything better than that, spoil. So I want you to log on and see what's happening in Paramin. You know, for years, Paramin had no water. You know that, right? For years, Paramin had no water. And I want you to take a look and listen. Guys, for you to see and to understand, you have to log on to the YouTube channel, Iowa TV. Or you have to go to Facebook, The Street 919 FM. That's the only way you would see what I'm talking about. You would hear it, but you have to see it. So, YouTube now, only give me a little 900 now. If only you love me, mm-hmm. Give me 900 this morning. I want to see the love. I want to feel the love. I want to touch the love and taste it. If only you love me, hit me a 900. So I'm going to play it for you. Yeah?
The Community Water Improvement Program of the Ministry of Public Utilities, executed by the Water and Sewerage Authority, continues to positively impact the lives of thousands of citizens in Trinidad and Tobago with improved levels of service delivery. The community of Paramin is the latest to now join this impressive list of projects completed under the program. The project was conceptualized to extract water from the Mia River intake.
Before this Mia River project was conceptualized, the residents of Paramin used this river as their primary source of water. They would use it for cooking, washing, bathing, everything. It's also a place where they would use as a recreation site. We constructed a weir wall. This is where we contain the water so that we can extract to go to our intake water facility. We are extracting about 120,000 gallons per day. Within the weir wall, we have our primary filtration system, which is strainers that will filter the debris and silt before it goes for the water treatment.
The water extracted from the intake will be pumped through interconnected 4-inch pipelines to two booster stations along the Lafinette Road.
Because of the remote location down in the valley here, receives power for the first time to run our pumps. From there, it's being pumped at this level up the first booster via 4-inch distribution line.
So we had a limitation of the amount of power we could have gotten off of the system, so that limited the size of pumps that we could have installed at each location. Now, being that we had over 1,000 feet of elevation to achieve with this flow, we had to break that up into three lifts, one being at the intake station, which would have lifted it up about 300 feet or so, then this station, which would lift it another 350 feet, and the last station, which is the booster number two, will take the remainder of the elevation up to the tank farm. We would have had to set up three booster pumps, 10 horsepower booster pumps, each with the capability of doing about 50,000 gallons per day. So we set it up in a two-duty, one-standby arrangement where two of them would have accumulated to the 100,000 gallons, and the other unit is there in case of any failures with any other units, we would be able to start it and maintain production without any disruption on the system. We also have some automation settings on here where we have flow sensors and pressure sensors, which would sends the water when it comes up the hill, automatically start the pumps and send it to the other location. Same as for the booster number two, that would have the sensors on the intake, which would tell it when to start and send the water all the way up. We have high pressure sensors on the discharge to prevent blowouts on the mains. We have overcurrent, undercurrent protections and stuff like that for any voltage fluctuations in the system.
This will result in the community being served reliably for the very first time, with an expected increase in the levels of service from 1 to 7 days per week in most areas. The completion of this project means the scenic and popular La Vigi site will also receive a pipe-borne water supply for the very first time. Some of the beneficiary communities include Upper and Lower Shodo Road, Mont Cyril, Mont René, Fatima Trace, Farmers Lane, Balata Trace, and Lafayette Road.
In addition to doing the new water treatment facility to supply Parliament and Environs, under the guidance of the Ministry of Public Utilities, we decided to upgrade the recreational facilities at the Mia River recreational site. So what we did is created a studio fountain and clean up the base to design a small park recreational site for that.
CBIP, serving communities, improving access.
And you know why I play this too? I play it particularly for some of y'all who are sent here, especially when I own, to come with your rhetoric and your gobar and your narrative that you want to spew. So I had to send you the right narrative. Because like the next one who come in from Masimoto's just now, talking Ralph Abercrombie. You in here? He say monkeys that get bride with house and contracts, eh? Ralph Abercrombie, I must report you to your workplace. This hour you supposed to be doing the people work. You on Facebook cussing people and calling them monkey? Is the same monkey meat all he does want to eat? Anyhow, let me hush my mouth before I get in trouble. But I had to show you. Because you remember the government ain't doing nothing. For the first time, Parliament has water. A 7 day a week water flow. Thank you, Mr. Marvin Gonzalez. I have somewhere else too, you know. I have another one that I think I could show you. I wonder if I have time. But I will make time. Bruce, I feel you might have to configure this one for me. I don't know. That's not what I would tell you. This one is in Tobago.
Is it?
Yeah.
Drag it across.
Drag it across. Come on, Sharon. Learn the thing, yes. Open up.
Check your volume.
Where my volume? I have to go back here now?
No. You're going right there. It may not bring everything across. Your volume
right.
Up.
All right. Volume, right?
Yeah, there is the volume on the one you now open, eh?
Wait, I just know. I know, wait. But where it only going, so? This is the one I just put in?
Start it back from the top and see.
Yeah. Come now, man. Stay with me now. Since all you want to talk, let me give all you thing to talk.
In the corner there, you see have a box in the corner, right-hand side.
Yeah.
Click that.
Right.
Good.
Okay. Nice.
Director of Operations at the Water and Sewage Authority, Shaira Ali, said the completion of the Parliament Water Supply Project is a milestone for the authority.
Previously, the community received a supply from Parliament Well 7 at the base of the Parliament Hill, and this supply was only able to reach somewhat to level 4. This supply was also inadequate to meet the demands of this growing community.
Since taking up office in 2020, Minister of Public Utilities Marvin Gonzalez said the ministry has been able to increase the water supply to customers of Wassa.
32% of the population was receiving a 24/7 water supply. Today, over 50% of the population is now receiving a 24 level of service, and other communities would have moved from once per week or twice a month, as the case may be, from 3 days a week to 4 days a week, 5 days a week. And that's the reason why when you turn on your television every night, you're no longer seeing people burning tires and creating all kinds of problems.
Minister Gonzalez is hopeful that water supply issues will continue to be addressed by Wassa.
We will give you the assurance that the issue of water supply in Trinidad and Tobago and the issues and the problems that we face will be a thing of the past.
Minister of Finance and MP for Dago Martin Northeast, Colm Imbitz, and the residents have been waiting for years for a steady supply.
The transformation from getting water once every 2 weeks or even once a week to every day is unbelievable, and it is only because you have a PNM government and you have a Minister of Public Utilities who is from this area, who understands the problems.
A tour of the Mia River intake was done, as the river will supply the water for the project. Two booster stations were also constructed as part of the project and the 185,000-gallon tank farm. Mahalia Joseph Wharton, TTT News.
Now, will you take that? You want to come and cuss me? That is a government working for you. You can vex how much all you want. I don't care who anti-PNM. I don't care wherever all you want to see. I don't care all you want to put. I don't care who don't like me because I just talk the truth. That is all your business. That is all your business. All you have to take me in small doses or in large ones. I don't business. The truth is the truth. I can't tell a lie if it's the truth. Come on. You want to cuss me? Come on. Cuss me more and I will bring out more. Yes, Brian, you're the last caller because we're going to close off the program in a short time.
I know. First of all, pleasant good morning to you, Bruce.
Morning.
Good morning to you, Miss Felix.
Good morning.
I'll take it out, Jesus. Felix.
Oh, I wait for spite.
I know that. I like it too bad.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Lex, I'm going to tell you this, I'm so happy you played it. I will tell you why. Remember what Minister Gonzalez just said? Before 2015, 32% of people was getting water.
Mm.
Before 2015, between 2010 and 2015, the UN, the partnership signed a contract with a family consortium. I keep repeating this. Paying them $7 million a month for water. But what percentage of the country? 40 million gallons a day out of 194 million gallons a day required to supply the entire country. You understand? And they won't get, many parts of the country wasn't getting water 7 days a week, or not less, sometimes 1 day a week. But a family is collecting $7 million until 2036, a 25-year contract. That is $14 billion. But you have CWIP now coming, easy as you like, with less money, and over 50% of the country getting water now. And nobody, no family consortium getting a $7 million to supply water to less than 25% of the country. And that is what I keep talking about.
Brian, not only that, at least people getting paid for a job done. A man exactly. Get a much billion of dollars for a water waste project. Up to now, all we see is a little concrete structure. Where the money gone?
And nearly $1 billion gone in Panama. By Mamu. And we can't see the money yet. And people talking in this country. We need Ralph Abercrombie. Write him up.
Ralph Abercrombie. And fast. Brian, I'm going to take Mr. Chance quick. We just have a minute. And I have to leave. Mr. Chance, you have 1 minute, my darling.
You know how to bruise, young bruise, how to love you, shell and speech, your plate, that is the icing on the cake. And I want to tell the people of Sani Grande Regional Corporation, just like what they heard happen in Parliament, that happened to you is millions and millions. Just a couple of days ago, I spent a day and more in Toco, from Valencia to Toco.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, if you see economic opportunities up there, I spent all the money going up the road, only buying this, buying people. People are really pulling out the little thing and shopping on the road going up. It was no PNM thing, but people going up to Toco.
Mr. Chance, and you forget I'm always up there. I'm regularly up there.
That's correct. And listen, everybody in the vehicle say, what? Them people here have to vote PNM. So Sani Grande Regional Corporation, and when I come back, I tell them all about business. We went across and look at the hospital. You know the development taking place in the hospital? So Sani Grande are looking for victory this time, the corporation, the amount of work done in Sani Grande Regional Corporation, the opportunities for people for employment and development. That is what we're looking forward towards. Thank you very much, Felix, for giving us that light in Parliament. Sani Grande people, take heed. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Happy birthday, Junel, coming out from Uncle Nigel and the entire family.
Trinidad and Tobago, this is where we got to leave it. I can't say no more. I said all that I have to say. Have a good weekend. We out of here. Ciao.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the street. 919 FM.
For a new on-the-go experience in radio, simply go to your Android device and download Instant Radio. Select Trinidad and Tobago and click the street. 919 FM. So you can listen to us wherever you want.
Why I have this big smile on my face? I got the keys to my home today. I did it with help from TTMF. And it was much easier than I thought. They can help you too.
The belief that the mortgage process is complicated should not stop you from buying a home. At TTMF, we can help you every step of the way. Visit us online or call us today. TTMF, from here to home.
This is the voice of the PNM.
PNM family, tell me, are you ready?
PNM. Calling all members, all supporters to the PNM special convention and presentation of our candidates for the upcoming local government elections this Sunday, June 25th at Napa Port of Spain. Doors open at 11 a.m. You must be seated by 12:30 p.m. Action starts at 1 p.m. Assemble your teams. Wear red. And let's bring the energy as we launch 141 of your winning candidates. Be there as the political leader of the PNM and Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, speaks on the future of local government. Reform is real. Performances by top soca artists, dance, tassa groups, rhythm sections, and more. See you on Sunday, 25th June, from 1 p.m. at Napa, Port of Spain.
PNM.
Great is the PNM.
Catch all your favorite shows live on Instagram.
Oh, yeah,
Instagram.
We're live on Instagram.
The Street, 919 FM. What are you waiting for? Go check us out on Instagram today.
Today.
Tune in to The Street 919 FM every Thursday from 10:05 a.m. to 10:20 a.m. for the program Straight and Narrow, The Way of Life, The Health Store, being brought to you by Mrs. Arlene Collins Mohammed. For more information, check us out on Facebook or Instagram at Straight and Narrow, or visit our website at www.opulence.com/Arlene4Life. You can also call or WhatsApp at 309-4697 or 620-9379.